Please remain standing for the posting of the colors and our Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
Wait till the color guard retires.
Parents, relatives, and friends. During the graduation ceremony, we will be reading the names of your children as they march onto the stage to receive recognition. Although you may want to clap, cheer, or call out to them as they walk, we ask that you hold your applause until the end. Our reason for this request is simple. If you are clapping, cheering, or calling out to your child, you will be interrupting the ceremony. The next student in line will not hear his or her name, nor will the family of that student. Therefore, we ask that you hold all applause until the end of the ceremony. There will be plenty of opportunity to clap, cheer, or call out the name of your student then, and many happy relatives will be doing so at that time. Remember that graduation is a formal occasion, and we want to have a ceremony that we will be proud of for years to come. Please help to support the senior class in a dignified manner this very important time in our lives. Now, I would like to share with you a poem that I wrote for the class of 2019. It is titled, As Time Passes. As a unit, we grew as a team. As children, we shared our dreams. We learned from those who have been through it all. Throughout those times, we have also learned to stand tall. To push our limits and to listen to the bell, we stood back up even if we fell. Acknowledged our mistakes and made new friends. Smiled, waved, and even made amends. As time passes, no matter what, we will show that from this moment forward, we will always continue to grow. At this time, I would like to welcome Ms. Ramsey to the podium.
Thank you, Oscar. Good evening, graduates, family members, school board members, faculty, and staff. Welcome to the 2019 Galileo Commencement Ceremony. A commencement ceremony is always such a special occasion, the culmination of years of hard work, the actualization of goals attained, and the acknowledgement of successes achieved. Seeing teachers, parents, and staff here tonight is a testament of the achievements to the graduates and the love and support they have received over the years. Parents, I want to thank you for bringing your children to our school and entrusting them with us every day. Galileo faculty and staff, I want to thank you for your dedication and commitment to our students each and every step of the way. Graduates, today is about you. It is a day to celebrate your accomplishments and successes. This is the day that you've been preparing for since you first sprinted into your educational career. You have finished the first leg of the relay, and this is an exciting moment in your life. Today is the day when one relay race ends and another one begins. It is easy to anticipate what the future will bring, but it is important to reflect on what you have accomplished. The Galileo Yearbook staff encouraged us this year to reflect on our legacy, both as a school and as individuals. Instead of giving you advice from my point of view, I invite you to listen to your peers. Before you begin your next race, take a moment to consider everything you have learned up until this point. What is the legacy that you are leaving behind?
So this is a bit of a cliche, but I guess to me it's a little bit less of a cliche because I run track and cross country, but it's like you're running a relay and the person who runs the first part passes on the baton, and then you run your part of the race and then you pass the baton. And so it's just you're working together even though you're all at different points in time. And it is a cliche to pass the baton, but You really are, and it's not like you finish the race and you're done. You go on to do other things. You run other races. You accomplish different things. You write essays. You inspire others. That's a very it's a bit of a conglomeration of examples I just used, but you can do anything with it, really. It's just inspiring others, motivating others to finish what you started or do their own thing.
So legacy means to me the path you leave behind, the memories you make, the people you meet, and your impact on them. So yeah.
That's good. What kind of legacy does Galileo have to you?
Coming into Galileo, I came from Sacred Heart, and I heard a lot of good stuff about Galileo. Like, it was a smart school, there's a lot of advanced classes, and you can go to the Institute, go to GW for AET, and there's a lot of good things about it.
What kind of legacy does Galileo have to you?
Galileo has the legacy of intelligent students. I feel like Galileo has this stigma of having different kind of students, and I feel like when I got here, they already had that predetermined legacy of this is the school you go to where you want to be yourself and you want to be different. So I feel like Galileo's legacy is full of just being yourself.
Short question, what kind of legacy do you want to leave behind?
Of course I want to leave behind a great legacy, drive the sports teams to an even further standard, and drive myself academically and really set the standard for Beta and Yearbook and leave behind and try to continue the legacy that the previous people have left for me.
Well, I'm about to graduate in like a week, so I would hope to have a great legacy to any rising seniors or any other students and teachers here. I was a part of the IB program in 11th and 12th grade, and I took like four classes of IB. And so I would just hope to like provide like an example of like hard work and dedication in those classes. And so yeah, I would hope that would be my legacy, to be known to be hardworking.
In 2002, Galileo took a journey into the future. Then, as reality set in, it pushed to escape the stereotype, to Ctrl-Alt-Delete, and further investigate the values and expressions of the educational experience. By observing the retro 80s and rocking and rolling out, the Falcons have endured the odyssey and called for an encore. Galileo encourages students to make your mark by asking the question, who do you think you are? Overall, we wouldn't change a thing, as we have treasured our journey and the lessons we have learned from the scratch work. We may be wired weird, but this is only because of our time on the front lines at Galileo. That is our legacy.
Thank you to all the students involved in making of that video. In addition, I would like to extend a special thanks to one of our graduates, Jennings Dean, for his creative direction and his technical troubleshooting. Many of the students in the video shared truths of what they hoped their legacy will be. Mary likened her legacy to passing a baton to the next runner. 4 years ago, you took the baton from the graduating alumni, and today you pass it along to the students who follow in your footsteps. Today, you are also receiving a new baton as you begin the next relay outside of Galileo. Oscar and Brendan encouraged us to be ourselves and to be different. No two runners follow the same path to success. You will get there in your own time. People say dance like no one is watching. Today, I encourage you to run your race like no one is watching. Run towards what makes you happy, because Emily is right. The path you leave behind, the memories you make, and the impact you have on others is what matters. The hard work and dedication that Kelsey encourages, coupled with the drive and the encouragement of others that Jackson finds instrumental, will ensure that your legacy is one to be remembered long after you've crossed the finish line. Glancing back as you take the baton and ensuring a smooth transition, remember us as you contemplate your handoff and take us with you in each relay of your life. In her 2012 speech at Galileo's commencement ceremony, Vicki Jenkins, first administrator at Galileo, charged the graduates to leave something behind when you leave this earth. Today, I stand before you and renew that charge. 2019 graduates, run your relay, pass your baton, pick up a new baton with new challenges, solve problems, and make a difference. And most importantly, Falcons, go change the world. Thank you. At this time, please welcome to the podium Danville Public Schools Superintendent, Dr. Stanley B. Jones.
Good evening. Parents, platform guests, visitors, and friends of our soon-to-be graduates, welcome to the 2019 commencement ceremony. On behalf of the school board and all who serve Danville Public Schools, I bring you greetings during this season of celebration. This is simply the time of year that is filled with excitement and enthusiasm because of these young folks in front of us. Given that excitement and enthusiasm, it would be wise for me to keep my remarks very brief. So to the class of 2019, I offer these remarks. First, it is my hope as you move beyond this day of commencement that you will find the one thing that is truly your purpose in this journey called life. It is also my hope that in finding your purpose, you will work daily and successfully to result in making our world better than when you arrived in it. In my humble opinion, our world and community need your talent, skill, and passion more than ever. Finally, in keeping of the theme of legacy, the legacy of Galileo High School in our community can be defined in one word, and that word is excellence. It is my hope that excellence will define how you live, how you lead, and how you love for the rest of your lives. Congratulations. This time I invite our school board chair, Ms. Terry Hall, to the podium.
Thank you, Dr. Jones. I also would like to thank Mrs. Ramsey for the opportunity to be with you this evening and the opportunity to introduce our school board with us this evening. We have our vice chair, Ms. Renee Hughes, if you will stand. Mrs. Elizabeth Leggett. Mrs. Crystal Cobbs. Mr. Jeff Hubbard. And Mr. Taekwon Graves. On behalf of the school board, We challenge you, graduates, to become lifelong learners, to never stop learning, exploring, growing, and challenging yourselves to be your very, very best. Congratulations to the 2019 Galileo Magnet High School graduates. Thank you.
Good evening. Devin Braun graduated from Galileo's International Baccalaureate Diploma Program in 2008 and attained his Bachelor of Arts and Master's in Public Policy from the College of William and Mary in 2012 and 2013, respectively. During his time at Galileo, Devin was active in the school yearbook and newsletter, played a leading role in the school's production of Shakespeare's play, As You Like It, and gave the salutatorian speech at his graduation. Devin currently works as a senior analyst with the Government Accountability Office in Washington, D.C., where he leads performance reviews of a range of federal programs currently focusing on the preparations for the 2020 consensus. Please welcome to the podium our guest speaker of the evening, Mr. Devin Braun.
Thanks very much. I realize I might be about the least popular person here at the moment because I'm the random alum who graduated over 10 years ago, and by speaking, I'm actually delaying the handing out of diplomas. So I realize I'm walking into a bit of a den here, but thank you for just a few minutes of your time, and congratulations to the graduates and to all of your families. It's a special day. I think that by standing here, I'm really an example of just how much can change over time and how far one can come. Just 11 years ago, I was standing in front of the Galileo community giving a speech at graduation. 11 years later, here I am, standing in front of the Galileo community giving a speech at graduation. Actually, I'm really a reminder of just how far one's hairline can go. Maybe you get an inkling about this, but for what it's worth, I was a pretty odd kid in high school, it turns out. I wore loafers, a sport coat, and shorts every day. I had a beard that wrapped around my neck like a warm, itchy glove. And I had this clip-on bow tie that I put on only for special occasions, like yearbook photos. The school newspaper, theater, Beta Club, soccer, and IB. I marked my days with these pursuits. But I also parked in the same parking spot every day for 3 years running. And I organized many of my hopes and dreams each week around when the cafeteria would serve those tasty chicken patty sandwiches. But what I got from high school was an indelible lesson that responsibilities to your future, to your teachers, your classmates, and your castmates, that these responsibilities don't disappear just because you're having an off day. To go through life after high school is to know that the nature of adversity is such that you don't get to pick when you face it. I remember thinking that when I graduated high school, I had hit the peak, the summit. SOLs, IB exams, AP exams, oral exams, written exams, eye exams. They had all been part of the process to get here. Here was the destination. If I made it to this point, I must have passed. Indeed, you just finished likely the hardest thing you have ever had to face thus far in your life. You stared down the gauntlet of teenage angst, braces, glasses, body changes, acne. Oh my God, the acne. I just described my ninth grade. All while absorbing intellectually challenging information. A real credit to you. What I want to challenge you to do, though, is try to picture yourselves 11 years from now. Lots of things can happen during that period of time. Jobs, college, grad school, marriage, possibly divorce, statistically speaking, and of course, kids. Hopefully not in that order, but anyway. 11 years from now, given all of that, do you really want to think of your current self at this moment as having been at the peak? With so many opportunities and challenges that will confront you between now and then, can you really imagine not growing from that? My advice, for whatever it's worth, start being your own harshest critic. Throughout your life, you will hear praise when you don't deserve it and criticism when you don't deserve it. Let yourself be your North Star, your guidepost, your judge and jury for how you're doing. If you can develop within yourself the ability to judge quality, whether in school, during a performance, or on the job, you'll be able to motivate yourself and weather the storm, depending on which is required. Today, I work for an agency that does oversight over the rest of the federal government. If I spent my days waiting to see and touch an immediate, quantifiable impact of my work in order to know whether it was good or not, I might actually go crazy. Rather, I have to do my job for the benefit of Congress and the American people, knowing that if I do it well, I'm contributing to a process that ultimately makes our government more responsive and efficient. Maybe not today, maybe not next year, but in the long run, we will all be better off if we as individuals hold ourselves accountable to high standards no matter what the outside feedback is. But take today and enjoy it. You've navigated a fraught, obstacle-laden course to get here. Remember that you didn't do it alone, of course. And know that the real gift of high school is getting the tools and perspective necessary to hold yourself to an even higher standard going forward, no matter the accolades, the criticism, or the noise. And just to close things out here, I want to thank, of course, GW for hosting us here. I do want to say, there was something about Galileo from the beginning, the combination of the diversity of the student body, which I see here in today's graduating class, the demandingness of the curriculum, the cohesiveness of the ecosystem and the community that existed. It was central to making me who I am today, for better or for worse. And I think hopefully it's had the same effect on you all graduating today. And so I will always count myself a fan and devotee of the little school that could and still can at the old Sears building in downtown. So thank you and congratulations to you all.
Thank you, Devin. We have a token of appreciation for Devin for bringing the 2019 commencement address. We are extremely proud of Devin and are excited to be to hear about his future endeavors.
Thanks very much.
At this time, please welcome to the podium Galileo's 2019 valedictorian, Ms. Janita Alvina Theodore.
Good evening. Thank you all for coming to this honoring ceremony for us. We appreciate it. As I was contemplating on what I should talk about tonight, I took to the internet and discovered that valedictorian, the word, comes from valedictory, which means a farewell address. So for this speech, I thought I'd take a walk down memory lane and look back on my educational career and discuss what I significantly learned from my experiences. I have attended 9 different schools thanks to my parents moving from one place to another, but don't worry, I won't talk about all of them, we'd be here all night. So I went to preschool in India, where I learned the alphabet from A through Z, yes, Z. A few years passed, and I suddenly found myself in a kindergarten classroom in Indiana, where I had to do some unlearning because here it's apparently A through Z. From there, we moved to Danville, where I was halfway through kindergarten. Here, I've had some amazing teachers that I will never forget and made some impactful friendships that got me through these years. So that's my first point. School can be, and sometimes was, fun. Don't get too caught up in your busy lives that you forget to have fun. In middle school, I still had good teachers, but I quickly discovered that there were distractions and that some did not appreciate school. So I learned to ignore the noise. That leads to my second point. To identify noise, ignore it, and continue to focus on what's important. Coming into high school, I had a choice of two schools ahead of me, and I'm so glad I chose Galileo, as I've come to like it a lot. And even though most of my friends chose the counterpart, I have still had a great experience. And that brings me to my next point. We're probably not going to see a lot of these faces ever again. And that's OK. We're going to make some strong friendships over the next couple of years that will last a lifetime. I would like to point out that so many in the community also played a vital part in our education, and I would like to thank them for all they've done for us. Next, I'd like to thank our teachers. The dedication of all our teachers and staff has been commendable in helping us formulating our goals and in also driving us to achieve them. I'm grateful for your constant reassurance and commitment to us. Shout out Mr. Smith for not being a sore loser every time you lost a game of Scrabble to me. I would also like to thank my family, who has been a constant support to me, and I especially would like to recognize my grandfather, who has come all the way from India for my graduation here today. He has always prayed for me and motivated me in my life to make an impact in this world and make it a better place. Also, Mom and Dad, wherever you are, because I can't really see, thank you for everything you've done for me, all the sacrifices you've made, the advice you've given me. I don't know where I'd be without you. I love you so, so much. Which brings me to my last point. Keep your family and friends close, because they stick by you and help you through anything that life hands you. As a closing statement, I'll just quote the Queen of Pop, since he says it best. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. Thank you. Congratulations, class of 2019.
Janita Alvina Theodore, we are extremely proud of you and your accomplishments during your time here at Galileo. I would like to present to you the Galileo 2019 Valedictorian Medal. Congratulations. At this time, please welcome to the podium Galileo's 2019 Salutatorian, Ms. Kelsey Louise Carter.
Good evening, parents, school board members, guests, and fellow classmates of 2019. It is an honor to be delivering the salutatorian address to you all today, and I extend to you a heartwarm welcome. I would first like to thank you all for gathering today in celebration of the class of 2019's achievements. To the teachers and parents especially, you have all had a profound impact on our development, and we are so grateful for your investment in us. Now, to my fellow classmates, the day has finally arrived and we made it. Most of us spent 4 years at Galileo, some of us five, and for the most part, this time has been full of hard work and dedication to get here. But who knew it would get here so fast? Over the course of my 5 years at Galileo, I've gained such strong friendships and bonds with fellow students and faculty. I would like to give a special shout out to Oscar, Cameron, and Leah, and my Ivy friends and teachers. I will miss you all so much. I have always felt welcome here, and it is bittersweet to be leaving the Falcon's Nest. I titled this speech, Yesterday, Today, and Tomorrow, because I think it truly reflects this moment in our lives. Yesterday is a reflection of our past as a class. Looking back now at freshman year, we have all grown and matured so much. I honestly cannot reflect on that year too much without cringing. However, I believe that this senior year has brought us closer together as a class than ever before. We have all experienced our last first day, last spirit week, last powder puff game, last exams, and so many more emotional last experiences as students at Galileo. We have learned so much thanks to our wonderful teachers. Our parents and loved ones are now looking at the young adults we have grown into. I would like to give a special shout out to my parents, Dr. Wanda Carter and Mr. Jerry Carter. I love you guys so much. I would not be standing here today if it weren't for you two, and I'm so grateful for the irrevocable love and support that you've given me. A quote that I think captures the spirit of today is from Natasha Bedingfield's song, Unwritten. And the quote is, "Today is where your book begins, the rest is still unwritten." Classmates, I want you all here today to understand that our lives are going to change moments after this ceremony ends. We will all go down different paths and journeys. Years from now, this will just be a distant memory. However, I hope that you all will cherish all the memories we have gained at Galileo over the years. And I hope that you will use the knowledge that we have gained as a class to spread your kindness and influence to whatever path you may take. Our senior year is a chapter of our lives that is now coming to a close once we walk out of this auditorium. And tomorrow, our new unwritten journey will start. We will experience our first college parties, dorm rooms, real jobs, and finally have the opportunity to truly find our authentic self. But overall, classmates, it is more than certain that we will have some highs and some lows as we part our separate ways. We will experience new and different people and environments throughout our adulthood. Some of them may be lessons, while others may be blessings. However, I am sure we will all one day reach success. Now, classmates, my last remark is this. As our Falcon motto always says, let's go change the world. Period. Thank you.
Kelsey Louise Carter, we are extremely proud of you and your accomplishments during your time here at Galileo. I would like to present to you the Galileo 2019 Salutatorian Medal. Congratulations. Will the Galileo Magnet High School senior class please stand? Junior Marshals, please present the 2019 candidates for graduation. While the candidates line up for receiving of the diplomas, I would like to share with you a few of the accomplishments of the class of 2019. As Kelsey stated in her speech, some have been here for 5 years. The class of 2019 consists of a few individuals who completed the eighth grade program here at Galileo during their eighth grade school year, and I myself also had the pleasure of teaching them. Thanks to the efforts of the class of 2019, Galileo ranked number 5 nationally in the WISE Financial Literacy Test. And ranked number 3 nationally in small school status. This test is given to students in 43 states. The class also contributed to the Scholastic Bowl state championship title in 2018. This class has also contributed to us earning the silver medal by the U.S. News and World Report as the best high school in America. As well as being named the top 2,000 high performing school by the Washington Post. The scholarship total for the class of 2019 is quite impressive. I do want to note that it is a combined total that reflects all awards offered by potential schools, even if our graduates chose not to attend their institution. This senior class has earned over $3,090,296. Please.
please take a moment to applaud the tremendous accomplishments of the class of 2019. Preston Drew R. Brandon Jones Bennett. Sandro Andreas Bianchi. Alexandra Catherine Booth. Ian Thomas Brand. Garrett Allen Campbell. I said Garrett. I didn't mean to do that. Kelsey Louise Carter. Nomair Nadeem Chowdhury. Jatavius Daquan Childress. Gabriel Alexander Van Dalton. Tyasia Lene Davis. Jennings Kevin Dean. Quindara Regine Emerson. Ivory Lee Freeman. Joshua Anthony Gates. Devin James Gordon. Edward. Trent Edward Gordon. Elizabeth Taylor Lee Gibson. Brianna Danielle Gill. Jacob Andrew Grazier. Trinity Anna Marie Green. Carlton Rodney Hardy Jr. Paul Francis Heron. Tracy Donnell Holland. Jacob Taylor Hutchinson. Isaiah. Denaje Isaiah Jackson. Brandon Jamal Jennings. William Zachary Jones. Tania Lorraine Keane. Oscar DeLon Kemp. Bruce Landon Kendrick. Nicholas Anthony Landon. Alexander Frazier Larkey.
Logan David Lukefar. Taylor Lee Mangus. India Lee Faith Marable. Devin Nicole McIver. Najee Imani Mitchell. Deshaun Khalil Morton Price. Crystal Marilyn Munoz. Amanda Jane Neely. Emily Elizabeth Nordan. Trevor Frankie Picario. John Wesley Perez. Angelique Nicole Perkins. Davis Slade Potts. Jordan Rashad Pridgen. Nicholas Justin Russell. Emma Grace Savoring. Chase Alexander Scott. Aaron Jasmine Sellers. Holly Kate Setliff. Rebecca Nicole Shadrick. Cameron Blake Shelton. Samantha Cheyenne Slaughter. Amanda Paige Talbot. Janita Alvina Theodore. Ajavia Quamera Toomer. Tashira Ann Terrain. Jonah Kim Tran. Rosemary Louise Tucker. Isaac Samuel Vanderveer. Leah Jamila Warner. And Paisiana Corlett Warren. Tabitha Armani Watkins. Madison Leah Webb. Heath Dustin Wood Jr. Catherine Ann Carter.
Cameron Denise Smith.
Candidates, please stand. You have successfully completed an approved program of study as set forth by the Virginia Board of Education and implemented through the Danville Public School System. Therefore, it is with great pleasure that I now pronounce you graduates. You may turn your tassels. Congratulations to the Galileo Magnet High School Class of 2019.